Oops, I made not one, not two, but three of these tops. Two of them for myself and one as a gift. And that should tell you something, right? This is a super versatile design that you can make in knits with stretch fabric and in wovens, fabric that does not stretch. And you can make it into a top, make it into a tunic, make it into a dress. The possibilities are endless. And if I can do it, then you can do it for sure. So without any further ado, let's jump into the drafting of the pattern and then let's sew it up. Now grab your pattern paper, and by the way, gift wrapping paper with grid lines on the other side works just as well. And we're going to start on this side of the paper. And the first measurement that we will need is the back waist length that goes from the nape all the way to your waist. Tying a cord or elastic around your waist is always a really great idea to make sure that your waist measurement stays in the same position no matter what other measurements you take in the process of drafting. Alright, now that you have this measurement, let's go ahead and put it in a straight line right over here. And once that is done, go ahead and divide it in half as well. So right in the middle, just make a little mark like so. Now let's take your bust circumference measurement and your waist circumference measurement as well. On our pattern, we're only going to be using a quarter of that. The quarter of your waist circumference plus half an inch of ease is gonna go right here on the bottom in a straight line, and the quarter of your bust circumference plus half an inch for ease is gonna go right over here in a straight line as well. So now we're gonna go ahead and take your back shoulder width measurement from one edge of the shoulder to another, going through the nape. Now half of that measurement is gonna go right over here, as you see me do on the screen. So here we have your waist, your bust, and your shoulders. So now let's go ahead and take the pattern and turn it like this, and we're going to start working with the neckline and the shoulders. So first, let's take care of the neckline. For the width and for the depth of my neckline, I'm going to take an even amount, 3.5 inches for both, for the width and the depth. For you, it might be a different amount. If you're not sure, go ahead and take a look at your favorite t-shirt or your favorite blouse. What are the neckline measurements there? And you can copy from there as well. If you're still not sure, you can just take 1/6 of your full neck circumference plus a little bit for ease, maybe 1/4 inch or 1/8 inch, and then you can use that measurement, but that will be right around your neck, so it's going to be a pretty tight neckline. So now I drew a little box which is 3.5 inches all around. From this point right over here, I'm going to raise my neckline by 1 inch. And from the edge of the shoulder, I'm going to drop it by 1 inch as well. Now, these are very approximate measurements for shoulder slope and high point shoulder. If you know your shoulder slope and your high point shoulder, then use your exact measurements. So now to complete the neckline, let's draw a really nice smooth curve. You can also use a plate or a cup to help you out with that. And of course, you have a French curve that will help as well. So now that we have the front neckline done, let's take a look at the back neckline. So here, to create a back neckline, we need to connect these two points very nicely with a smooth curved line. There we go. Now, this is the back neckline, this is the front neckline. For this next step, we're going to create a shoulder seam. So we're going to connect these two points with a straight line. So grab your ruler and let's go ahead and do that. So now go ahead and grab your pencil and a ruler, and we're going to drop a straight line from the edge of the shoulder all the way to the bust line. So here's my pencil and here's that line. So a straight perpendicular line. And now we're going to draw another curved line right over here in this little corner. It doesn't have to be perfect, as it is actually going to be changed, but as of right now, it will serve us as a guide. And now let's go ahead and extend the pattern. Since we started building our pattern from waist up, I'm going to extend my top by 4 inches down. You can extend by whatever amount that you want. And for the width of that measurement, we're going to take 1/4 of your full hip circumference. And if you'd like, you can add about 1/2 inch to it to ensure that you have extra width at the hips. Because let's say if you want it to be tunic length, you don't want it to be super tight. Now let's connect with a pencil all those three measurements, your bust, your waist, and the bottom of your top. Now because mine is way too steep over here, I'm going to extend by about 1 inch right over here, and then I'm going to create a really nice and smooth side seam line. The key here is that you want for it to look organic. You want for it to look like it was meant to be this way. You don't want any sharp corners that would look really awkward once the garment is made. And once you're happy with the line that you drew, go ahead and outline that, and the side seam is done. So one more look at the side seam from this angle, so that way it really is clear how it's done. And here I have to say that before we begin drafting an actual raglan sleeve tops are usually drafted from a base of a regular t-shirt or a regular shirt with a normal sleeve. So this is kind of like a shortcut without doing the base and drafting a raglan sleeve right away. So on the front neckline, we're going to take about 2 inches from the top of the neckline, and that's what I'm marking right over here. Now for you that might be a different amount, for me it's 2 inches, and that is going to be the beginning of your raglan sleeve. Now go ahead and take a ruler, and we're going to connect these two points, and do that with a pencil since we're actually going to be adjusting it in a little bit. So go ahead and connect those two points first. And again, you might want to take more than 2 inches. You might want to take less than 2 inches. If you have a favorite raglan top, you can copy that measurement from there. Now we need to adjust this line. So this little squiggle right over here, we're actually going to merge it like you see me do on the screen and create a really nice curved line that is going to be at the bottom of our raglan sleeve. Alright, so now onto the sleeve itself, and first let's extend the shoulder line. Just go ahead and grab a ruler and a pencil, lay it on top of the shoulder line, and extend it in the direction that it's pointing you. Now once that is done, from the bottom of the armhole, find a perpendicular line, like so, and now you need to measure the distance. Now the distance from the bottom of the armhole to the sleeve needs to be at least half of your upper arm circumference plus 1 inch, so that way you can freely move your arm inside of your sleeve. If it is not, like in my case, go ahead and raise the sleeve by the necessary amount. Necessary amount would be the difference between what the width is right now and the width of half of your upper arm circumference plus 1 inch. And you see, I have redrawn the line right over here. Now, to mark the actual width of the sleeve all the way down, I'm going to use exactly the same width, which was half of my upper arm circumference plus 1 inch, and I'm going to mark it perpendicular or parallel to the top of my sleeve right over here, and you see I'm doing that on the screen, and that is going to mark the bottom of my sleeve. And once that is done, let's go ahead and move to this next step. Go ahead and grab a new piece of tracing paper or pattern paper, and now we're going to copy some of the elements. We're actually going to copy the lines for the back pattern piece. So we're going to copy the center back, we're going to copy the back neckline, and of course the bust, waist, and the bottom of the pattern as well. We are not going to copy the front neckline and the sleeve line as well, because for the back pattern piece, it's going to be a little bit different. So let's go ahead and get that done. Now for my back neckline and back sleeve pattern, I will also take 2 inches from the edge of the shoulder all the way down the neckline. And then as you can see on the screen, I am also creating the bottom line of the sleeve on the bodice, just like we did for the front pattern piece. Once that is done, you will have the front pattern piece and the back pattern piece with sleeves all in one. So let's go ahead and cut the pattern pieces of the bodices away from the actual sleeve patterns, as you see me do on a screen as of this very moment. You will do that for both the front pattern piece and the back pattern piece as well. Now to tidy up the bottom of the sleeve, let's go ahead and find a perpendicular line that goes from the top of the sleeve to the bottom of the sleeve, and then cut away the excess, and that is going to be the bottom of our sleeve. And after that, the last thing that we have left to do is to make sure that we actually invert the curve of the sleeve, and the easiest way to do that is to take the bodice, put it on top of the sleeve, match the points of the neckline and the underarm, And just copy that curve, and that will give you a better fit of your raglan sleeve and ensure that there's no excess fabric in the underarm section. And that's it. Cut away the excess, and your front pattern piece of the sleeve is ready. Here you can clearly see this negative space that we created by inverting the curve of the sleeve. Now once that is done, make sure that you mark your pattern pieces in these wear for the front sleeve and the front bodice. Now you will repeat exactly the same things for the back pattern pieces, for the sleeve and for the bodice. Make sure that you mark them as well, just like you see me do on the screen. And once done, you will take the pattern pieces for the sleeve, here you see the front and the back, and you will line them up like so. Grab some scotch tape, or you can also copy this on the fresh piece of paper, whichever way you prefer. In this case, I'm grabbing some scotch tape and I'm just taping them together, and that will create our raglan sleeve, easy as that. And now you see, this is one pattern piece. Here is the neckline, and here is the bottom of the sleeve. If needed, you can also tidy this up to make sure that this really is straight at the 90 degree angle, and our sleeve is done. Now you have your back pattern piece, your front pattern piece, and the sleeve, and we can start cutting our fabric and sewing this up. Here's a quick reminder, if you are a member of this channel, first of all, thank you so much from the bottom of my heart. I truly appreciate it. It is a paid function, a way to support this channel, but in return, as a member, you do get quite a few perks. And one of the perks are instruction sheets for drafting steps for the projects that you see in my videos. And you do have latest instruction sheets for this particular project. So definitely head to membership tab to see the latest perks and many others. If you're not a member and you're wondering what this all is about, then I will leave links and useful information in the info box below underneath this video. All right, well, let's roll with the rest of the project. Since you can make this either out of knit or woven fabrics, let's talk about the cutting steps. Now, you will need to cut the front one piece on the fold, back one piece on the fold, and two pieces for the sleeves. When you're cutting woven fabrics, please follow this grain line. When you're cutting knit fabrics, the biggest amount of stretch should go widthwise, and definitely follow the stretch direction that you see on your screens as of this very moment. For woven fabrics, I would also recommend adding a little bit of extra ease in your sleeve, but we will talk about it in just about a second, and I will show you how it looks on the actual example. When you're cutting your fabric, please remember to add your seam allowances as you see on this example, as I do not add any seam allowances as I draft my pattern, but I do always add them as I cut my fabric. This is just the way that I like to do it, and I actually recently made a full video on the type of seam allowances that are out there, what kind of I personally like to use, and why. So definitely take a look. I will leave that video for you guys in the info box below. Here you can see the sleeve, and the sleeve is shorter than the original sleeve that we drafted. As you can see, all I did, I just took the sleeve and I folded it in. So it's really easy. If you need to make it a little bit shorter, just fold it in and that's it. If you need to make it a little bit longer, we will discuss that in just about a second. Now this is going to be a short sleeve knit top, and here you can clearly see I've added my seam allowances and my hem allowances as well. So one more time, please do not forget that. Now I've taken my front pattern piece, my back pattern piece, and the sleeve. The front and the back are laying face down, and here's the sleeve. The principle of putting this together is going to be exactly the same whether you're sewing with knits or with wovens. It might depend on what kind of seam finish you're going to choose, but the idea is going to stay the same. First, I'm going to take my back pattern piece and the sleeve, and placing them right sides together, I'm going to align the curves that we previously inverted on the pattern. Once that is done, go ahead and pin it together, and that's how we're going to sew the back pattern piece to the sleeve. Now, in order to attach the front pattern piece to the sleeve, we're actually going to do exactly the same. You're going to take your front pattern piece, right sides together with the front of the sleeve, going to align those inverted curves, place them, and pin them. After that, you're gonna head to your sewing machine or your serger, and you're going to sew them. Now here I have pinned the front and the back at the same time. However, you don't have to do it this way. If it's easier for you to do one at a time, please do one at a time. It's really important to find what works for you. And I'm also using a serger, but you don't have to use one if you don't have one. The zigzag stitch on your sewing machine will do just fine. Once that is done, go ahead and lay your top like you see me do on a screen. Side seam to side seam, sleeve seam to sleeve seam, and we're going to pin this whole thing because we're going to sew it all in one go from the bottom of the sleeve all the way to the armpit and then all the way to the hem of the sleeve. Here it is really important to match everything up and to make sure that all of the seams look really nice, especially if you're using two different fabrics like I am doing in this example. Once you have sewn both side seams, your t-shirt or your tunic or your top is pretty much done. Now here all you have to do is finish the neckline, hem the sleeves, and hem the bottom. And I do have a full mini series on how to do that for your knit project, so I will leave that whole playlist in the info box below, since it guides you step by step on how to do the neckline and the hems and everything else. So you can definitely choose what you like and then finish your project. Well, how to go about making a long sleeve top like in this example. The basic principle of constructing the top is exactly the same thing. The only two differences is going to be A, the length of the actual sleeve, and B, the bottom of the sleeve if you don't want it to be as wide and you want it to be closer to the width of your wrist. Now, it's really easy. First, you will need to measure your hand and the length that you need. And the second thing is you want to measure your wrist circumference and add a couple of inches to that so that way it's not too tight. So basically, your hem of the sleeve is going to be not as wide as the mid part of the sleeve itself. So if you lay one on top of another, as you can see me do in this case, you will clearly see the difference. And really, it is as easy as that. Alright, so we have sorted both of the knit tops, and knit tops are pretty straightforward. But what about the woven top? Since I did mention that in order to ensure mobility of your sleeve so that way you can actually move in it, if I were you, I would add some extra ease to it. And here's how to do it. We have two options. Option number one is to slash the sleeve exactly where you did combine the sleeve from the front and the back pattern piece. So you're just separating the sleeve, easy as that, and you're adding extra width in the middle of it. However, it will add length at the neckline, so your top is going to be a little bit longer in the neckline and overall. So that's option number one. Option number two is to slash your sleeve along the same line where you did combine the front and the back. However, instead of separating the sleeve on equal amount all the way vertically, you're actually going to leave the neckline as is, and you're going to spread the bottom of the sleeve, giving extra volume at the hem and also at the mid part of the sleeve. So option number two is exactly what I did for my woven top. And then the bottom of the sleeve, since it did come out quite voluminous, and I actually wanted that effect because the whole idea was to insert an elastic, and that's exactly what I did. The mini series on how to finish a woven garment will be linked for you in the info box below, but here's a quick rundown. The neckline is finished with the bias tape. The sleeve is finished with elastic in the casing, and we've done that on the channel before. The bottom hem, which is also slightly curved, is finished with a quarter of an inch wide pin or rolled hem that I do on the sewing machine without a rolled hem foot, and I do have a video about that. So I will leave all of that in the info box below for your convenience. The seams on the woven top are stitched with a straight stitch first and then finished with a serger. However, you can achieve exact same result with doing a straight stitch and then doing a zigzag stitch on the edge. Or perhaps if you'd like, you can go for French seams. And all of that will be in the mini series on how to finish a woven garment. And here you have it, one pattern and three different tops. And here I really want to encourage you with this video to turn on your creativity, to look beyond what you see and really have fun with your sewing and with your imagination. Have a wonderful day. I truly hope this video was helpful, and I will see you in the next video.